सुधागड एज्युकेशन सोसायटीचे पूर्व प्राथमिक, प्राथमिक, माध्यमिक व उच्च माध्यमिक विद्यालय कळंबोली मराठी, हिंदी, इंग्रजी, उर्दू माध्यम यांच्या सौजन्याने शैक्षणिक व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपलं सर्वांचं स्वागत आहे।
गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट, today we are going to see the same lesson, that is similarity. Our today's concept is similar triangles and the test of similarity of triangles. Now recall here once again what is meant by the similar triangles. Here I have drawn the two triangles. These two triangles having same shape but not having the same size, that means the two triangles are called similar triangles if they are having the same size, same shape, but not necessary the same size. Now second condition, if two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles are always equal. If two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles are always equal. Then third condition, if two triangles are similar, then corresponding sides are in the same proportion. Corresponding sides are in the same proportion. These concepts we had learned in the previous standard. See, focus this figure carefully. Here the triangles are congruent. This triangle, this angle y, it is shown by the letter y, and in this angle is shown by letter y. That means these angles are congruent. Here angle x congruent with angle x, angle z congruent with angle z. That means if two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles are always congruent and their corresponding sides are always in the same ratio. See, the ratio I have put here, A upon P, that means this side and this side. Ratio, if you take this ratio, then that ratio is equal to the ratio of remaining sides, that means B upon Q and C upon R. So here we come to know that if two triangles are similar, then their sides are in always proportion, or their ratio are always same. Now this is about the similar triangles. This concept we had learned in the previous standard. Now here next we are going to see some tests for the similar triangles. First test, AA test. Here in AA test, A is what? Angle. If two corresponding angles are equal, this test is also called as if two corresponding angles are equal. Second test, SSS test. If three corresponding sides are in the same ratio, if three corresponding sides are in the same ratio, then we can apply this test to show the two triangles similar. Then third, SAS, side angle side. Here what is the meaning of this test? The ratio of two pairs of corresponding sides are equal and their included angles are equal. Here ratio of these two corresponding sides are equal and included angles are equal, then we can apply this test to show the two triangles similar. Now next we can see the brief how these tests are we can apply to show two triangles congruence. See in a brief. Here we had seen the first test, that is AAA test for similarity of a triangle. Here we can say AA test also. That means if two angles are congruent, then automatically three angles are also congruent. So see the first test, AAA test for similarity of triangles. So see here two triangles are drawn here, triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Here angle A and angle P, they are shown by the equal sign, that means angle A congruent with angle P. Here angle B and angle Q, they are shown by the equal sign, that means angle B congruent with angle Q. Then angle C and R, they are also shown by the equal sign, that means angle C congruent with angle R. So here three angles of triangle ABC are equal to the three angles of triangle PQR, then both the triangles are similar by AAA test of similarity of a triangle. So see once again, how can we write or theoretical part we can mention here. See what is given here. For a given correspondence of vertices, when corresponding angles of two triangles are congruent, then the two triangles are similar to each other. Okay, I once again repeat here. For a given correspondence of a vertices, when corresponding angles of two triangles, these are corresponding angles of these two triangles are congruent, then these two triangles are said as similar triangle. See here, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, here this is in the correspondence ABC having one-to-one correspondence with PQR. What is the meaning of this one-to-one correspondence? Angle A congruent with angle P, angle B congruent with angle Q, and angle C congruent with angle R. This is called as a one-to-one correspondence of these two triangles. It is very important. So here, three angles of the triangle PQ of triangle ABC congruent with the three angles of triangle PQR, then these two triangles are said to be similar triangle by AAA test of similarity of triangles. Here we can apply AA test of similarity of a triangle also. Now see the next test. SAS test of similarity of triangle. SAS test of similarity of triangle. See what is given here. What is the test mentioned here? For a given correspondence of vertices of two triangles, if two pairs of corresponding sides are in the same proportion, that means ratio of these corresponding sides are equal and the angles between them are congruent, then these two triangles are said to be similar triangle. See the two triangles drawn here, triangle KLM and triangle RST. Some measurements are mentioned here, KL 1, LM 2, here RS is given 1.5 and ST is given 3. So first of all, according to this test, here one angle is congruent. We can show that angle L congruent with angle S. This is drawn by showing the equal sign. That means this equal sign shows that this angle is congruent with this angle. So here we can mention or we can say angle KLM is congruent with angle RST. Then one pair of angle we have shown congruent, then take the sides which are in proportion. We will check whether the ratio of these pairs of these triangles are congruent or not. Take the first ratio, KL upon RS. KL upon RS, here KL is 1 upon 1.5. If we give the simple form to the ratio, then we will get 2 upon 3. The second ratio, LM upon ST. LM upon ST, LM is 2, ST is 3. If this ratio will become 2 upon 3. That means this ratio become equal. So here this ratio are equal, that means two pairs of corresponding sides are in the same proportion. If ratio is equal, then we can say that these corresponding sides are in the same proportion and angle included between them is congruent, then these two triangles are similar by SAS test of similarity of triangle. So once again I repeat here, for a given correspondence of the vertices of two triangles, if two pairs of corresponding sides are in the same proportion, that means their ratio is equal and angle included between them is congruent, then these two triangles are said to be similar triangle by SAS test of similarity of triangle. So this is our second test. Now see the next one. SSS test for similarity of triangle. SSS means side test of similarity of triangle. So what test is given here? See that for a given correspondence of vertices of two triangles, then three sides of a triangle are in proportion to the corresponding three sides of the another triangle, then these two triangles are similar. See here, two triangles are drawn, triangle PQR and triangle XYZ. Here if we take the ratio of the corresponding sides of the triangle, then that ratio is equal. So here P PQ upon YZ is equal to QR upon XZ is equal to PR upon your QR upon XY is equal to PR upon XZ. That means three sides of this triangle are in a same proportion with the three sides of this another triangle, then these two triangles are said to be similar triangle by SSS, test of similarity of triangle. I once again repeat the test. For a given correspondence of vertices of two triangles, if three sides of this triangle of a triangle are in a proportion to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then these two triangles are said to be similar triangle by SSS, test of similarity of triangle. Now, might be you understand these three tests. Now, see some properties of similar triangle. First property, triangle ABC similar with triangle ABC. That means any triangle is similar to itself only, and this property is called as a reflexivity. Any triangle is similar to itself only, then that property is called as a property of reflexivity. Second one, if triangle ABC similar with triangle DEF, that means first triangle is similar to the second triangle, then we can say triangle DEF also similar with triangle ABC. That means second triangle is similar to the first triangle, and this property is called as a symmetry. Third, if triangle ABC similar with triangle DEF and triangle DEF similar with triangle GHI, then we can say triangle ABC similar with triangle GHI. That means if first triangle similar to the second triangle similar to the third triangle, then we can say first triangle similar to the third triangle, and this property is called as a transitivity. So these are the three properties of similar triangle. First one is reflexivity, symmetry and transitivity. Now, might be you understand the test we had learned previously. AA test of similarity, SAS test of similarity and SSS test of similarity. By using that concept or by using that test, we are going to solve practice set number 1.3. Let us see example number 1. Here, question number 1 is given like this. In figure, angle ABC 75 degree, it is given here. In this figure, angle ABC 75 degree, angle EDC is also given as 75 degree. Then state which two triangles are similar and by which test. Here we have to show which two triangles are similar to each other, and also we have to show tell the test by which test these both the triangles are similar. Also write the similarity of these two triangles by a proper one-to-one correspondence. That means we have to show the proper one-to-one correspondence, and we have to prove which two triangles are similar and by which test. So consider first triangle, triangle ABC, this bigger triangle, and another triangle EDC, this one, this smaller triangle. So here see the solution. In triangle ABC, this bigger triangle, and triangle EDC, this one smaller triangle. Now, as we learn some test previously. Previously, we had learned some test, A test of similarity. Okay, so using that test, we are going to solve this example. So, to apply the AA test of similarity, here we have to show some pairs of angles which are congruent. So, see, the figure itself tells us which pair of angle is congruent. Okay, so here in triangle ABC, angle ABC is 75 degree. It is given to us. And in triangle EDC, angle EDC is 75 degree. It is also given in the question. So these two angles are said to be congruent angle. Why they are congruent? Because they are having the same measurement, and it is given in the question itself. So here we can say angle ABC congruent with angle EDC. why they are congruent, because they are having the same measurement and this information is given us in the question. So here we can give the reason as given. Now one pair of angle which we are getting congruent. Now we will search second pair of angle which is congruent. Okay, so in case of triangle ABC, that means this bigger triangle, angle ACB and angle ECD, in this angle is coming in both the triangle, that means angle C is common in both the triangle, and we know that common angle is always congruent. So here we can say angle ACB is congruent with angle ECD because these two angles are common angle and common angles are always congruent. So here in the second step we can give the reason as common angle. Now in this both the triangle, two pairs of angles we are getting congruent, that means automatically third angle is also congruent. Okay, so here sufficient to show these two pairs of angles congruent. So as two pairs of angles are congruent, then we can say triangle ABC similar with triangle EDC. By which test? By AA test of similarity. Why we apply this test? Because two pairs of angles are congruent in this both the triangle. That's why these two triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. AA means what? Angle-angle test of similarity. So might we understand the application of the test of similarity? See the second question. Read the question carefully. Are the triangles in figure are similar? Are the triangles in figure similar? That means they ask the question. Are the given triangles are similar? And if yes, by which test they are similar? That means we have to prove these two triangles are similar and by which test they are similar to each other. So as the information given in the question, here we have to think about the site, because we had learned of the test of the similarity, three tests of similarity are there. So which test we can apply here? As length of the segments are given here, then we can think about the ratio, about their ratio. So here we will check the ratio one by one. Here PQ upon LM, first ratio we will take PQ upon LM. Here length of PQ 6, LM is 7. Here we can divide this ratio, the division will come 2. That means value of PQ upon LM is equal to, we are getting here 2. Then second ratio we can take QR upon MN. Here value of QR 8 and value of MN 4. Here again if you divide this 8 by 4, the division will come 2. That means value of this ratio, that means QR upon MN, is also getting 2. Then check the third ratio, PR upon LM. PR upon LN is equal to value of PR 10, LN 5. Divide this ratio, you will get the answer as 2. If we check the value of 3 ratio, these 3 ratios are equal. That means the sides are in same proportion. In this both the triangle, the value, this value of these 3 ratio is equal. That means we are getting here sides are in proportion. So in triangle APQR and in triangle LMN, we can show PQ upon LM is equal to QR upon MN is equal to PR upon LN. Why these 3 ratios equal? Because their value is same. That means these 3 ratio are in proportion. So here for this step we can give the reason as from equation number 1, 2 and 3. As here we are getting the sides are in proportion, then we can say triangle PQR similar with triangle LMN. By which test? Side test of similarity of triangle, because we are getting here 3 sides which are in proportion. Okay, triangle PQR. See here, might be you understand the question number 2. Here, in this both the triangle, we have shown these three sides are in proportion. That means these two triangles are similar by SSS, test of similarity of triangle. Might we understand this question? Now see example number 3. Read the question carefully. As shown in the figure, two poles of height 8 meter and 4 meter are perpendicular to the ground. If the length of shadow of similar smaller pole due to sunlight is 6 meter, then how long will be the shadow of the bigger pole at the same time? So according to question, here figure is drawn. Two poles of height 8 meter and 4 meter are perpendicular to the ground. So here I have drawn these two poles, pole AC and pole PR. First pole having height 8 meter and another pole having height 4 meter. And these two poles are perpendicular to the ground. This is your ground. Okay, these two poles are perpendicular. That means this angle is 90 degree and this angle is also 90 degree. Then what is given in the question? If length of the shadow of the smaller pole, here smaller pole, the shadow of the smaller pole is given as 6 meter. The length of the shadow of the smaller pole is given as 6 meter. Then how long will be the shadow of the bigger pole? So here we have to find the length of the shadow of this bigger pole. So the length of the shadow here we mention by x, and the value of x we have to find in this example. Might be you understand the question. Once again I read the question. As shown in the figure, two poles of the height 8 meter and 4 meter are perpendicular to the ground. That means they make the 90 degree angle to the ground. The length of the shadow of the smaller pole due to the sunlight is 6 meter. Then we have to find the length of the shadow of this bigger pole. And the length of the shadow of the bigger pole we had represent here by x. Now, to find the value of x here we have to think about this triangle. If we show these two triangles similar and then their sides in proportion, then we can find the value of x in this example. So here let us start to solve this example. First of all, what is given in the figure that we can mention here? PR and AC, these are the two poles as shown in the given in the question. Here we can say PR and AC are poles. QR and BC are their shadows. Here shadow QR is a shadow of the pole PR and BC is a shadow of the pole AC. So here we can say QR and BC, these are their shadows. Okay, then these shadows are cast at the same time. That means if the shadow are cast in the same time, these two triangles are similar to each other. Why they are similar? Because shadows are cast at the same time. If the shadows are cast at the same time, that means angle Q congruent with angle B, and it is already given in the question, angle R congruent with angle C. Two pairs of angles we are getting congruent. That means these two triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. So here, as the shadow are cast at the same time, we can say triangle PQR similar with triangle ABC. Now we know that if two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are in proportion. Okay, so here we can write the pair of corresponding sides. Here we have to think about the side PR, then QR, side AC and side BC. So here only two pairs of sides we are taking in proportion. So first pair we can take PR upon AC. PR upon AC is equal to QR upon BC. QR upon BC. Here we can write the reason in bracket, corresponding sides of similar triangle. Here we have wrote the simple form or the short form of this statement, corresponding sides of similar triangle. Okay. Now this ratio we are getting equal. Now put up the respective values. Here value of PR 4, value of AC 8 is equal to QR 6, it is given to us. Here value of BC we assume as x. Now put up the respective values. After that we have to do the cross multiplication here. 4 into x, that is 4x is equal to 8 into 6. Okay, this after doing the cross multiplication, we will transfer this 4 that side. After going there, that will undergo division. So 8 into 6 divided by 4. Here we will divide this 8 by 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So x is equal to, we are getting 12. 6 twos are 12. That means value of x we are getting 12. That means we can say length of the shadow of this bigger pole is equal to 12 meter. So mind you understand the solution of this question. Now let us see example number 4. See the question given here. Read the question. In triangle ABC, AP perpendicular to BC, BQ perpendicular to AC. Here B dash, P dash, C. B dash, P dash, C. That means these three points are collinear. Then A dash, Q dash, C. These three points are collinear. Then we have to prove that triangle CPA, CPA, that means this triangle similar with triangle CQB, CQB. We have to show these two triangles similar. Then if AP is equal to 7, BQ is equal to 8, BC is equal to 12, then we have to find length of AC. First of all, here we have to show triangle CPA similar with triangle CQB. Okay. So to show these two triangles similar, we know the test of similarity that we had learned previously. Here some information related angles is given to us. That means we have to think about which test, that is AA test of similarity. So to show these two triangles similar by AA test of similarity, we have to prove the two pairs of angles which are congruent. Okay. So in this both the triangle, here we will search to which two pairs of angles are congruent to each other. So let us start to solve this example. Let's see the solution. In triangle, first of all, highlight your triangles. Which triangle? Triangle CPA. CPA and triangle CQB. In this both the triangle, here angle C is coming in both the triangle. That means angle C is common. And common angles, we know they are always congruent. So here we can say in triangle CPA, that means this triangle, angle C, what is the name of the angle C here? Angle PCA is congruent with angle QCB. That means in this triangle, angle C is there. And what is the name of this angle? Angle QCB. Okay. So angle CPA congruent with angle QCB, which is common to each other, and common angles are always congruent. Then second pair of angle we can search in the figure, angle CPA congruent with angle CQB. These two triangles having measurement equal, as they are equal measurement, that means they are 90 degree. Okay. So as both angles having 90 degree measurement, we can say these both angles congruent. So here in this both the triangles, two pairs of angles we are getting congruent. So therefore we can say triangle CPA is similar with triangle CQB by AA test of similarity. While writing the name of these two triangles, here we have to check the one-to-one correspondence. See, one-to-one correspondence should be there. Then and then only the next step will be correct. We know angle C is congruent with angle C. That means angle C should be in the first position while writing the name of these two triangles. Then angle Q, angle P and Q are congruent. So in the second place, angle P is there. Here also, in the second place, angle Q should be there. Okay. So this is a proper one-to-one correspondence. By using that, we have to show the two triangles similar. Then as two triangles are similar, we are getting here, as two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are always in proportion. So here we can say AP upon BQ is equal to AC upon BC. So these are the two pairs of segments we are getting. These two pairs we are shown congruent. That means this we can give the reason to this step as corresponding sides of similar triangle. The sides are in proportion we are getting as these two triangles are similar to each other. Now put up the respective values over here. Your AP we know it is 7, BQ 8 is equal to AC we have to find. So AC we can write as it is, BC is given as 12. Now solve this, you will get the value of AC. So for that make the cross multiplication here. 8 into AC is equal to 7 into 12. Now transfer this 8, that side that will undergo division. So 7 into 12 divided by 8 is equal to, here 12 sevens are 84 divided by 8. If we make the division of these two numbers, you will get length of AC and this is 10.5. So in this way we can solve this example. First of all we show the two triangles similar by a test of similarity. Okay, then by showing the sides in proportion we find here the length of AC. Next question. See example number 5. In a trapezium PQRS, side PQ parallel to SR, AR is equal to phi AP and AS is equal to phi AQ, then prove that SR is equal to phi PQ. Here we have to prove that SR is equal to phi PQ. First of all, we will start the solution of this question by the information given in the question. We know that quadrilateral PQRS is a trapezium. Okay, so here we can say quadrilateral PQRS is a trapezium and side PQ parallel to side SR. It is given to us in the question. Okay, then as side PQ parallel to SR, here we will take the transversal PR. So after taking transversal PR, a pair of angle we are getting congruent here, which is that see the figure carefully. PQ parallel to SR and PR is a transversal, then we can say angle APQ, that means this angle is congruent with angle ARS, that means this angle. These two angles are nothing but the alternate angles and we know that alternate angles are always congruent. Therefore we can say angle APQ congruent with angle ARS. And we can give the reason in the bracket as alternate angle. Now, here, angle PAQ, this angle is vertically opposite angle of angle RAS. And we know that vertically opposite angles are always congruent. So here we can say angle PAQ congruent with angle RAS. And we can give the reason for this step as vertically opposite angle. Now, here in this triangle, PAQ and triangle RAS, first pair we are getting congruent, this pair we are getting congruent because this is one of the pair of alternate angle, and this pair we are getting congruent because these are the nothing but the vertically opposite angle. So we can say triangle PAQ similar with triangle RAS. Why they are similar? Because two pairs of corresponding angles we are getting congruent. Therefore, both the triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. Now, as both the triangles are similar, we know that their corresponding sides are always in proportion. That means their ratio is always equal. So here we can write the pairs of corresponding sides. First pair, AP upon AR. AP upon AR is equal to AQ upon AS. Here AQ upon AS. Then PQ upon RS. So these are the three pairs of corresponding sides which are in the same proportion. So here we can give the reason. corresponding sides of similar triangle. Okay. Now first part of this question we are completed here. Here first in the first part we show these two triangles similar and the pairs of corresponding sides we show equal. Okay. Now to reach towards our proof, here we will use the information given in the question. So this information we will use here. We know that AR is equal to phi AP. This is given to us in the question. AR is equal to phi AP. Now here I will transfer this AP these sides. So this AP will undergo division. So what ratio we are getting here? AR upon AP is equal to phi. This statement we are getting here by the information given in the question. Now here to reach towards our proof, here I will make the inverse of these two sides. Okay, by the process of invertendo, we know in the process of invertendo we can make the inverse of this ratio. That means here AP will go in the numerator and this AR will comes in the denominator. The steps we are doing here, same step we can apply for the remaining side also. So by the process of invertendo we can write AP upon AR. We take the inverse of this ratio. What is the inverse of this ratio? AP upon AR. Here AR upon AP is given. So inverse of this ratio is AP upon AR. Just this AP go upward and this AR comes down. So inverse of this ratio is AP upon AR. So the things we did in the this side, same step we are going to do in the next side also. So what is the inverse of this phi? It is phi upon 1. 1 is not written here, but it is there. So what is the inverse of this phi? It will be 1 upon phi. So this ratio I am getting here by the process of invertendo. So AP upon AR is equal to 1 upon phi. Okay. Now from equation number 6 and 8, here as AP upon AR, the value of AP upon AR I am getting here 1 upon phi, then I can say PQ upon RS is also 1 upon phi. Here in equation number 6, I just put the value of AP upon AR as 1 upon phi is equal to this PQ upon RS. Okay, as these three ratios are equal, if the value of this ratio is 1 upon phi, then value of this ratio is also 1 upon phi. So what I am getting here? 1 upon phi is equal to PQ upon RS. And I can give the reason for this step as from equation number 6 and 8. Now again make the cross multiplication, because here we have to reach towards our proof. What is our proof here? SR is equal to 5 PQ. So here to get this we make the cross multiplication here. So what is the cross multiplication? 1 into RS, that is RS is equal to 5 into PQ. Okay. So this RS is nothing but SR is equal to 5 PQ. So this is our proof. Okay. So once again, I just explain once again in a brief. Here to prove this SR is equal to 5 PQ, first show these two triangles similar by applying the A test of similarity. Then write the sides in proportion and then use the information given in the question, and using that we can reach towards our proof. Okay. So this is the solution of this example number 5.